All right, this is very important. We all saw how ardently Republican Congressman Devin Nunes defended the president during the impeachment hearings, pivoting and pointing to the Bidens.
No conspiracy theory is too outlandish for the Democrats. You would think they would take some interest in Burisma, and you think they would be interested in Joe Biden. We need to subpoena Hunter Biden. I think one of the mothers of all conspiracy theories is that somehow the president of the United States would want a country that he doesn't even like, he doesn't want to give foreign aid to have the Ukrainians start an investigation into Biden's.
Now, remember what he just said, okay? That he cannot accept the idea that the president would want Ukraine to be looking into the Bidens. Why would he cast so much doubt on an idea that POTUS had it out for the Bidens and was trying to use Ukraine to do it, when he is now allegedly a part of those efforts? Let's bring in Vicky Ward right now. She's got the reporting. Now, let's be very clear. We understand from Mr. Lev Parnas' lawyer, the man under indictment for doing certain things with campaigns, allegedly, also working with Rudy Giuliani, maybe paying Rudy Giuliani for certain other things, his lawyer. What does he say?
So his lawyer says that Lev Parnas would like to come and speak to Congress, mm-hmm. and that he would say to Congress, were he given the opportunity, that last December, Devin Nunes, the senior Republican presiding over the impeachment hearings, went to Vienna and met with Viktor Shokin.
Viktor Shokin, the person who was the prosecutor for Ukraine that Ukraine and everybody in the United States wanted out for not investigating corruption.
Correct. And who was fired in 2016 under pressure by many Western leaders, including our then Vice President Joe Biden. He has an axe to grind against the Bidens. Viktor Shokin is the man who has claimed to have dirt on Joe and Hunter Biden. He has claimed to have evidence that Ukraine meddled in our elections.
Reportedly met with Rudy Giuliani, Mr. Shokin.
Absolutely. So Shokin,
Rudy Giuliani wanted to get him a pass to come to the United States, and it was denied.
Absolutely correct.
All right, so next big question. How do we know that Nunes met with Shokin?
So it gets interesting. So Shokin tells Lev Parnas, Rudy Giuliani's associate, who's Ukraine-born. And what's interesting is that Nunes comes back and tries to recruit Lev Parnas. He does recruit Lev Parnas to merge his effort, his and Rudy Giuliani's investigations, with his. He has an aide meet with Lev Parnas, and they discuss how to reach out to various Ukraine prosecutors who might have information on the Bidens.
Right, so hold on a second. This is a lot. So Devin Nunes, who's at the hearing, and I'm sorry, but I'm learning this from
you. This is new reporting.
Devin Nunes at the hearing saying, this is crazy that the president would want Ukraine to look at the Bidens. The prosecutor, who was the one at the center of all the controversy, met with Nunes in Vienna last December. So before all this other stuff that they're saying was just about one phone call.
Way before.
Months before. Shokin then tells Parnas, the shady guy at the center of all this, and then Nunes's staffer meets with Parnas.
So does Nunes. Nunes meets with Parnas. Nunes speaks to Parnas.
About dirt on the Bidens.
Several times, yes. They're asked to merge operations, essentially. So in other words, you know, this whole impeachment, Chris, is about a shadow foreign policy that Devin Nunes appears to have and some involvement in.
So he knew it was going on. So he knew they were looking for dirt on the Bidens.
Right. He is a drama in this play himself, and yet he has not told anyone about this.
All right, so sourcing becomes everything. This comes from Parnas's lawyer, all right? That this is what Parnas wants to testify to.
Yes.
So now you got to reach out to the parties. You got to go to Nunes. What does Nunes say?
Right, we've been trying to actually get in front of Nunes in person. Mm-hmm. Two of my colleagues went to see him on the Hill.
Did they give him information about why?
They absolutely did, and this is not exact word for word what Nunes said. To be perfectly clear, I don't acknowledge any questions from you in this lifetime or the next lifetime.
To be perfectly clear, I don't acknowledge any questions from you in this lifetime or the next lifetime. Knowing how central this consideration is to what's going on in the impeachment right now, he won't even say it's not true.
Right.
All right. Now, Viktor Shokin, okay?
Yes.
What is the chance of getting to him on this? Because obviously he can confirm or deny also.
Well, I have his phone number, so I've texted him, I've got to him, we've reached out to him. He's not talking.
So everyone's getting a chance to respond. They know what the story is. They know what the allegations are.
Right.
And we're hanging this on Parnas's lawyer. So theoretically, Parnas would say the same thing, but you're just hearing it from his lawyer.
Correct.
Parnas wants to testify, and the lawyer is saying this is what it would be about.
And he has, by the way, actually been subpoenaed.
Right. So...
But there's an issue, Chris, remember, because he's under indictment by the Southern District, so his lawyer would like him to be given essentially immunity to speak freely.
Well, let's think this through. You've been thinking about this a lot,
yeah.
I know, with your team. Why would Nunes say it is preposterous, or whatever word he used, ludicrous, something bad, to think that the president would want Ukraine to look into the Bidens when... Evidently, he knew Rudy was looking into the Bidens, and he was trying to get Ukrainians to do it, right?
Right, Parnas right.
Fruman are Americans, but they're Ukrainian-born, right?
Yes, yes, yes.
And then shouldn't he have disclosed that he went over to Austria, to meet with Shokin?
Well, what's so intriguing, for want of a better word, about his whole trip was the timing of it. And in fact, his aide, Derek Harvey, told Lev Parnas that the timing of it was very deliberate. It was done right after the Republicans lost the House in the midterms, but before the Democrats took over.
Why?
In January, because once the Democrats took over, he would have had to disclose the details of it. So this is why nobody has known until now what Devin Nunes was doing last December.
That the committee was told about his actions?
No. The only thing that's reported in the congressional record is that he and Derek Harvey and two other aides went to Europe.
But they don't say who they met with.
No, and this was quite deliberate, according to my reporting, according to the lawyer speaking for Parnas. Derek Harvey, the aide, told Parnas that the timing was done deliberately to keep it undercover.
Vicky Ward, thank you for the reporting. Thank you for working. Look, we want it fair. Mr. Shokin, if you're listening, tell us what happened. Mr. Nunes, this is about the truth. Come on and tell us what happened. Don't say you're not going to answer the questions. You have to. That's your position. Vicky Ward, thank you so much.